And Luca, I'm curious to know from last year to this year, in terms of your playoff experience, what was the biggest thing you learned about the intensity of the playoffs, knowing the things that guys like Marcus Morris and the Clippers were trying to do from a physicality standpoint?
I don't know, but that's, I think that happens in every playoff series. So I think everybody's going to be ready for that.
Brad Townsend?
Yeah, Luca, your three-point percentage went really high in February and March and dipped in April and May. Do you feel good about your shot right now? How much of a recharge were you able to get with these with this little time off?
I think I got some rest, some working, because we've been playing every other game. But my point is, if the shots don't go in, you know, drive the ball, make somebody else score, play defense, and the priority is win the game, not if shots go in. To win the game, that's the priority.
Okay, Tim McMahon.
Luca, the Mavs announced today that the playoff crowds in Dallas will be close to normal capacity. I'm curious your reaction to that and how much you think basically a sellout crowd can impact the game.
For sure a lot, because, you know, we play for the fans, and I'm really glad that our fans will be able to see our games, and I hope we give them back with a win.
Callie Kaplan.
Yeah, Luca, we've heard stories throughout the season about you making bets with other guys, whether it's for half-court shots or video games or whatnot. So I'm curious, how do you decide what bets you do or don't want to make, and what's maybe been your favorite that you've won with guys on the team?
I don't know. I just make a bet, you know, even if it's not realistic. I just won $100 against J.J. Redick again. So this is the next thing he can talk about on podcast.
All right, we'll do two more in English. Eddie Sefko.
Luca, Dorian said something about this a day or two ago. I'm wondering, did you feel any like you guys were being disrespected because of the way the Clippers kind of finagled things down the stretch and lost to a couple of lottery-bound teams to, it seemed like, to get in your bracket or to get you guys?
No. I mean, there can be plenty of reasons, but I don't really pay attention to that. You know, I'm more focused on us.
Okay, Lawrence Murray with The Athletic.
Hey, Luca, last year in the playoffs, it seemed like those were high-scoring games. They were really fast-paced games. And during the three meetings between the Mavericks and Clippers this season, it felt like three of the slower games in the league. I'm not sure for the Mavericks, but certainly the Clippers already being a slow-paced team, like, those were low-scoring affairs. Like, what kind of games do you prefer to play, especially against the Clippers? Like, do you prefer to speed the pace up, or are you more comfortable when it's kind of a slower paced game?
I don't really know the answer to that question, but I'll go with anything that gets you a win.
We will go into Spanish now. Ariana.
Perfecto. Hola, Luca. Ariana de Telemundo. Bueno, tu segunda serie de postemporada, nuevamente una serie de postemporada ante los Clippers. ¿Es una ventaja enfrentarse ante el mismo equipo en términos de que ya conocen el análisis de estrategia para enfrentar al dúo Kawhi Leonard y Paul George, o es más presión para ustedes porque tienen esa necesidad de revancha?
No creo que nada de eso. Si quiere ganar un anillo, tiene que ganar todos, así que no creo que importe lo que a los que nos enfrentamos antes o después.
Okay, and one more, Carolina. Carolina, go ahead.
Hola, Luca, ¿qué tal? Carolina Coronado, Estrella TV. Quisiera saber si un año después que afrontas tus segundos playoffs, te sientes con más madurez para estos playoffs contra los Clippers.
Bueno, siempre se aprende algo, ¿no? Cada partido se aprende algo y siempre aprendes algo nuevo. Y bueno, creo que sí, pero también tenemos que ver cómo jugamos y ojalá jugamos bien, ¿no?
Gracias.